Hi friends, in the last episode we discussed what is a news article and what is a feature and how to write them. Today we shall move on to look at the differences between news article and feature. There are three essential differences between an article and a feature. They are time, style, and structure. By nature, news articles are time sensitive. They are usually written before an incident or immediately after or as an issue breaks out. But features are not. They are not time sensitive. They can be written at a time of your choice, on a topic of your choice. Freedom is more in features. An article adopts a simple style while a feature is more creative. Content is the focus in an article, and so simple words are used to convey the message. In a feature, the writer makes an attempt to attract the reader through creative use of language and literary forms, imagery, allegory. In an article, the writer should distance himself from the subject, whereas a feature writer can be subjective. Lifestyle features often follow the first-person narrative. You'll find the I coming up frequently in such features. An article speaks about the issue in the lead itself because it always uses a direct lead. The news is conveyed upfront without missing any detail in an article. On the other hand, a feature delays direct reference to the issue and uses a delayed lead to retain reader attention. Feature does not have a particular formula the way a news article does. An article follows the inverted pyramid structure, which conveys the who, what, where, when, and why, and how. A feature can begin with a dramatic moment and then uncover the history that led up to that moment. There can be a format of a story within a story in which the writer uses a different person to narrate the story. An article can have a maximum of 350 words, whereas a feature can run up to even 2000 words. Especially if it gets published in the net edition. The writer of an article has a deadline, but a feature writer can relax a bit. The article writer faces space constraint, but a feature writer has a bigger space. Article writing is about being frugal and compressing all necessary details within a short space. A feature writer does not have such constraints. Let us see a couple of examples to illustrate these points. The first one is a classic CNN article, and it is about an attempt to clean up the Pacific Ocean. This CNN article, written by Ahisa Garcia and published on October 16, 2018, speaks about a unique attempt to clean up all the plastic in the Pacific Ocean. As we saw earlier, a news article follows a simple style, has most of the details of the issue it speaks about in the lead itself, and follows an inverted pyramid pattern. It talks about the 5 W's and the H, Let's have a detailed look at this article. The heading is, "This floating pipe is trying to clean up all the plastic in the ocean." The first paragraph, the lead, a 2,000-foot-long floating pipe nicknamed Wilson is about to start its mission to collect all the plastic in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. Last month, the Ocean Cleanup Foundation launched the world's first ocean cleanup system out of San Francisco to take on the notorious Great Pacific Garbage Patch, a giant floating trash pile between San Francisco and Hawaii that is twice the size of Texas. It is the largest of 5 ocean trash piles on Earth. First, this article follows a simple style. In the 2 paragraphs, the lead, you have not come across even a single word that requires a dictionary. Also, the first 2 paragraphs answer the W's and how questions. Why, what, when, where? Why? Because a giant floating trash pile is found between San Francisco and Hawaii that is twice the size of Texas. Where between San Francisco and Hawaii, the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. And also, it uses the by getting answers to the W's and how, we find that this feature follows the inverted pyramid structure. When you read further, you will come across a distinct simple style, which is readable, as I said earlier, even by a school student. The pipe is set to arrive at its destination in the ocean on Tuesday and begin the cleanup process soon after, according to a company spokesperson. Then it describes the pipe. With about 150 million tons of plastic in the world's oceans, and that number expected to triple in the next decade, this type of trash disposal has real implications for climate change, the safety of sea life, and industries such as fishing and tourism. You find more details, more figures, more authentic data that follows. The article also quotes an authentic source. That plastic is still going on to be there is in 1 year. It is still going to be there in 10 years, said 24-year-old Ocean Cleanup founder and CEO Boyan Slat. It's probably still going to be there in 100 years. So really, only if we go out there and clean it up, this amount of plastic is going to go down. So it contains all the elements of a typical news article. Another feature of this news article is the narrative here is in the third person, and the first few paragraphs give you almost all details you require. This draws you down to the article where you have more information about plastic pileup in ocean, how it is very difficult to remove such piles. The second example is that of a good feature published in the Independent of UK. This is about overcoming insomnia, but the writer starts with a different scene. Let's have a look at it. This article, published on February 15, 2011, starts like this. Does anyone not like raisins? A packet of raisins was handed out. I would like you to imagine you are aliens. you have just flown down to earth. Everything is new and you have been presented with a raisin. Hold it in the palm of your hand and notice how it looks, how it feels. Gently push it around and notice its color and texture. If you want to, gently pick it up between your thumb and forefinger and notice whether it feels hard or soft. Maybe put it up to your nose and see if it smells, and to your ear and see if it makes any noise. And when you are ready, put it in your mouth and use your tongue to push it around. Maybe notice how your tongue feels and how the raisin feels. And very gently pop it between your teeth and notice if there is any taste to it. This is the kind of lead followed by the writer in this feature, which is about insomnia. In the initial paragraphs, in the first two or three paragraphs, we did not come across even a single word which has any relationship with either sleep or sleeplessness. The first few paragraphs did not even answer the questions for why, what, where, when, and how. But here comes the lead, the delayed lead. The silence was broken by a whimpering. Libby, at 19, the youngest in our group, was sobbing. "I feel really anxious," she blurted out. "I was on the inaugural Time to Dream Sleep retreat at Rockcliffe Hall, a 5-star hotel set on a restored 18th century estate on the banks of the River Tees in County Durham. Here you find a description of the setting and the purpose of writing this. It is a workshop to cure insomnia in a 5-star hotel." Leading our group of a dozen dotty souls, ranging from chronic insomniacs to those with more humdrum sleep disorders, was Guy Meadows. Here a person is introduced, a sleep expert with the air of a young Tony Blair, who practices at the London Insomnia Clinic in Little Venice. Meadows, 33, who has been studying human physiology for 14 years, 9 of which have been devoted to sleep research and the prevention of sleeping disorders, was not short of energy himself, having recently become a father and been part of a charity team that swam the channel. "It's amazing," he said of the raisin exercise, "that sometimes like that can." "It's amazing," he said of the raisin exercise, "that something like that can." "Freak you out," said a now composed Libby, who normally gets 1 to 3 hours of sleep per night. Having observed that her reaction was quite common, Meadows explained that the exercise was designed to raise awareness levels and was part of an approach to insomnia based on Buddhist-inspired mindfulness. You'll find that the style adopted here is totally different from what you normally apply for writing news articles. Here, the style is flowery, a bit creative, not matter of fact. The lead is delayed. The author, the writer consciously avoids speaking to you about sleep or sleeplessness. He starts with a raisin exercise and relates it to the treatment given for curing insomnia. After learning about the characteristic features of a news article and a feature, we saw in this episode the essential differences between these two types of writing. Though both a news article and a feature appear in a newspaper, maybe the feature sometimes or most of the times appear in pullouts in magazines, in pullouts that accompany the main edition, there is a distinct difference. The basic difference is on style. The liberty a feature writer enjoys is greater than that of an article writer. And also, the space available for an article is short, whereas a feature can be longish. It can run up to 1,000 words, 1,200 words, even 2,000 words. But in the case of an article, it can be a maximum of only 350 words. For an article, you have to follow the conventional pattern of answering the who, where, what questions and how question in the lead itself, which is a direct lead. In the case of feature, it is an indirect or a delayed lead. You don't find information on the topic. For example, we saw this article on insomnia, where a group is getting treated for sleep disorders. But nowhere in the initial three paragraphs you find anything remotely connected to sleep or sleeplessness. On the contrary, there's quite a description of a race scene, how to enjoy a race scene. It is not possible in an article because an article should be straightforward. It can only talk about in a very honest way what happened. Like in the case of using a device to clean up the Pacific Ocean of plastic waste. It is straight. The article contains more information, more data, more figures, whereas you can easily avoid using data or figures in a feature which is more flowery, more creative. Having seen the differences, let's attempt to write articles and features in the form they are intended to be. Thank you.